Girl, sometimes I wonder why I even became a teacher. Especially when the parents won't come to the school to support their own children.
I know, right?
If I ever had a child, I would make sure he had the best of everything.
Girl, I know exactly what you're talking about. Well, I'll talk to you tomorrow. Good night.
Good night. Look, I don't know if you can hear me, but I have been praying, asking that you would give me a sign that you have forgiven me. If I ever have another opportunity to be a mother, I will. I just ask that you help those who have to make a decision. That young woman that's scared or not sure or believing that she doesn't have a choice. I often wonder what my child would have become. What he looked like. Girl, get a grip. God ain't listening to you. You gotta carry that guilt for the rest of your life. If your friends ever found out what you did, they'll never talk to you again.
Hello. For a kiss.
What are you doing in here? Get the hell out of here. Look, I don't know what you want, but my purse is on the dresser. My jewelry is in the top drawer. What are you doing here? Are you gonna rape me?
I'm not here to do that. I'm not trying to hurt you.
Look, if you don't get out of here, I'm gonna call the cops.
Call them. Because if they come, I won't be here.
Girl, you gotta stop eating ice cream before bed. Having crazy dreams like this.
No, you're not dreaming. I'm your son.
I don't have a son.
I know, but you could have.
What are you? Is this some kind of sick joke? Who put you up to this?
No, it's not a joke. It's not a nightmare. And it's not something you conjured up in your mind. I'm your son. Well, what could have been? And I'm not mad at you. I understand. You see, Mom, I am your child. You used to hum that to me when we were alone. When you found out that you were pregnant with me.
I didn't have a choice. I would have lost everything I was working for. My scholarship to college, my respect, everything. But I promise you, I loved you.
You had a choice. But you made your choice based upon him. You lost your respect the moment you slept with him. So don't use the word respect. And you, how do you know that you would have lost your scholarship? You are a smart woman. He told you that he loved you, and you believed him. You made your choice based upon him, not what you were feeling. But I'm not mad. I understand, you were young.
I didn't want to do it. I'm telling you, the choice wasn't mine, it was his.
Why do you still keep this? I'm not angry that you didn't decide to have me. But look what else you gave up.
What are you talking about?
Your dreams. Like most people,
You not only made the choice to not have me, but you've been doing the same thing with your dreams. They're waiting to be birthed by you. Every time someone tells you that it won't work, you give up. Like your ideas for the students, you gave up. Your dreams to make a difference, you gave up. Your dreams to travel outside of the state, you gave up. Mama, why are you giving up your dreams, your purpose, your vision?
Why are you doing this to me? What did I do to deserve this?
Same question I asked myself. Why are you taunting me by keeping me around in your thoughts? If you didn't care, why do you blow me a kiss every night? When you could have kissed my cheek, and I would have kissed you back, hugged your neck. But now the only thing I can do is watch as you grow older. Why are you still asking God to forgive you? He didn't choose, you did. So why do you keep the picture of the sonogram of me around? Why?
Because I wonder what it would have been like to be a mother.
I would have loved you no matter what. Some days we would have laughed. I would have loved to learn your voice and been able to answer you. Like the time you rubbed your stomach and sang to me. But I'm not angry with you.
Please, just stop this. I just want to live my life.
So did I. You felt me. You knew I was there. I gave you sign after sign after sign that I wanted you as my mother. I wanted to live.
I'm sorry. God knows if I could turn back the hands of time, I would do things differently.
Everyone says that. People always say that if they could turn back the hands of time, they would do things differently. But I'm sorry to tell you, they would not. People still have dreams, visions, and goals, and they abort them every day with some lame excuse. There are more dreams in the grave than there are babies.
I'm telling you, I would have kept you. I would have fought for you. Every day I live with the regret of not having you. I walk around here smiling, but inside I drink the water of shame, guilt, and remorse.
You don't have to walk in that anymore. Your pain and past mistakes can help another person make the right choice. And I'm not talking about having a child. I'm talking about dreams. Encourage another person to not get defeated by peer pressure, society pressure, and fear, but to live their dreams.
I'm so sorry. Will you ever forgive me?
You're forgiven, Mama.
Girl, you are forgiven. Now live.
Half of pregnancies among American women are unattended, and about 4 in 10 of these end in abortions. About half of American women will have unattended pregnancies, and nearly 3 in 10 will have an abortion by age 45.
I'm talking, Mom. I know the situation is personal, but it's something that has to be told. As I was making this beat, you was all I could think about. You heard my voice.
Yeah. Just think. What if you could just blink yourself away? Just wait. Just pause for a second.
let me plead my case. It's the late 70s, huh? You 17, huh? And having me, that'll ruin everything, huh? It's a lot of angels waiting on their wings. You see me in your sleep, so you can't kill your dreams. $300, that's the price of living.
What?
Mommy, I don't like this clinic. Hopefully you make the right decision and don't go through with the knife decision. But it's hard to make the right move when you in high school. Now you gotta work all day and take night school. Hopping on the bus and the rain is pouring. What you want, morning sickness or the sickness of morning?